Hello and good morning from Proactive New York. Joining me today from ESE Entertainment is CEO Konrad Wasiela. Konrad, good to see you again. How are you?
I'm great.
Lots to get to today. I want to first start off with some really interesting news. We did see the Saudi Arabian government-backed Savvy Gaming Group has bought esports groups ESL and FACEIT for a combined $1.5 billion. From my understanding, these are one of your main competitors here. So what do you think this says about the space?
Well, it's unbelievable. First, you saw Microsoft make this massive $70 billion acquisition of Activision Blizzard, and then this in the esports specific sector, $1.5 billion US. It's just great for the industry. It shows you how big the opportunity is. And most importantly for us, it shows us how big our company can get. So $1.5 billion US is the new mark in the industry.
Huge number there. I want to get to some recent initiatives that you've also been active in. It looks like that you formed a metaverse division. Talk us through that. What was kind of the reasoning behind that?
Yeah, with all this happening, you know, all these big gaming publishers are being very vocal that they're entering into the metaverse space. We work closely with all those big publishers. So we internally built our own metaverse business unit. And it's really exciting because we already landed our first contract. So obviously, it was the right move to make as a company, and we're excited to scale that business unit.
This is, from my understanding, with a group called Skinwallet. Tell me about them.
Yeah, correct. So we landed our first contract with Skinwallet. They specialize in skins and NFTs and blockchain technology, and we're going to be working together on several projects over the next several months. But as I said, it's really exciting to see a contract come in that not only generates revenue, but profits, and it's specifically in the metaverse. So very exciting times, and it gives us a new revenue vertical as well.
Very exciting. Lastly, I do want to bring up that the group is producing a live esports event on January 30th out of Warsaw. You must be happy that things are going back to in-person now.
I think everybody should be excited. I mean, it's just a great sign. You know, esports events are back in person. So live events, this is obviously huge for our company too, because we obviously produce online events, but now with live events coming back, once again, another revenue stream for us. And it's just great to see that things are turning and people are getting back to live events.
Yeah, let's hope it stays that way. Konrad, good to see you. Thanks a lot.
Likewise. Have a great day.